Kids, Miss Christy, did you hear the breaking news?
Breaking news? Did you finally throw out your sweatbands?
No.
You cleaned your half of the office?
No, not that.
Did you give up Burger King Whoppers once and for all?
No, not that.
Okay, well, I give up. What's the breaking news?
Mr. Dodgers is retiring from his show, Mr. Dodgers Area, surrounding a particular place. What?
What? That man's a legend. Who's gonna take his place?
That is the exciting part. They're holding open auditions today. Wanna go watch?
Totally. I bet people are gonna be coming out of the woodwork to audition for that role.
Okay, the line is, kids, let's give a warm welcome to our next guest. Judy, you're up first.
Now hop on your feet and show some respect to our first guest. Kids these days.
Next.
Thank you very much.
You haven't done anything yet. Next.
I don't give warm welcomes, but I do give warm hugs.
You can't hug the audience. I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. Next. And who are you again?
Mrs. Hobbin Wheeler. Here to do some learning with the kids.
Next.
I don't mean to be unkind, but this is the worst set I've ever seen in my entire life. Awful.
Next.
Warm welcome you give.
Next.
I'm so tired.
I'm sorry, miss, but this audition is for adults only.
But I brought my retainer and my hairball collection. Lots of good hairballs.
Next.
It's me, Mario. I am gonna win.
Win? This isn't a competition show. You just need to welcome our next guest.
Here I go. Mamma mia.
Okay, that's a wrap.
Whoa, those auditions were crazy. It's gonna be tough to find a decent replacement.
Elijah's time on Earth was coming to an end, and God had a perfect replacement.
God led Elijah to a man named Elisha, and he would become Israel's next prophet. He had some really big shoes to fill.
Let's take a look at how it all went down. Go ahead, hit pause. Watch the Bible story, Elijah and Elisha, and then come back to us when you're done. Could you be
mine? It's a neighborly. Right? Elijah had really big shoes to fill. Elijah had been God's prophet for a long time. He was kind of a big deal.
He was like a legend.
But Elijah couldn't have done any of the miracles apart from God.
Elisha may have felt that he wasn't ready, but he obeyed God and was very close to Elijah. Wherever Elijah went, Elisha went too.
The people's hearts were still hard toward God, but he had a plan for them. God chose Elisha to continue Elijah's work as a prophet. Clearly, God had no plans to give up on his chosen people.
God continued sending prophets to lead his people back to him. Even in the rebellion, God still loved them. Just like your parents don't stop loving you when you're naughty.
Oh, Violet! Ow! What are you doing? Are you pulling my hair?
Elijah must have done all of his miracles with his super coat. All he needed was that coat. Do you think it still exists? Because I would really like to get some work done around this house.
No, Chrissy, it wasn't the coat. I mean, Elijah did use his coat to part the waters of the Jordan, but it was only by God's power that those waters stopped flowing, just like he did when the people of Israel crossed over into the promised land.
There is one true God who alone deserves worship. God did another incredible thing when he took Elijah to heaven in the whirlwind.
Sometimes God uses miraculous displays of power to lead us to him. And other times he uses people to help us to get to know him better.
Elisha had been learning from Elijah along the way. He had seen God's power displayed through Elijah. I'm sure those memories stuck with him for years and helped solidify his faith in God.
I'm going to get Elijah too.
Right, we all need an Elijah. We need an older Christian or a mentor or a teacher in our life to help us grow in our faith. I know that God has given me those, and I watch them react to the difficult curveballs that life throws at them, and they react by faith and trust in God, and it encourages me to do the same.
Me too. Elisha knew that he would be the next prophet to Israel, and he wanted to make sure that God's Spirit would be with him too.
Only with the help of the Holy Spirit could Elisha carry on the job that Elijah had.
God gave Elisha the same Spirit that was in Elijah so that he could carry out his mission as a prophet. Years later, Jesus told his followers to wait for the Holy Spirit. God gives believers the Holy Spirit so that they can share the gospel with the world.
God gives us the power we need through the Holy Spirit. He helps us to resist sin and temptation, helps us to display the fruit of the Spirit, and to love and obey God.
How awesome that we have access to that kind of power. Let's go ahead and pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for sending us your Holy Spirit to give us the power we need. And we thank you for providing us with teachers and mentors to show us how to live. We love you. Amen.
This will be our last online lesson for a while, but we hope to see those gorgeous mugs of yours at church or at Awana. And our Bible story videos will still be available on Northgate Kids Online.
Thank you, kids, for sending us pictures and videos and participating in our family challenges. It has been so much fun.
Yes, you guys rock. Thank you.
Later.
Oh, goodbye, you little lima beans. Next time I'll bring you a pie.
Till next time.
Bye, children. I'll be on my way. Ta-ta for now.
I hope to see you all in person sometime soon. We can move on from fractions to division. Let's do some dividing!